Another wonderful Sunday here at church. We are all here to worship God and, you know, together as a big family. So we are so glad that you guys have kept your promise with God today. Now, are you guys ready to worship? Make sure you guys have your Bible, your offering, your activity booklet, and your ready heart. Now, let's all get ready to worship as we start off with prayer. Let us pray.
I'm fixing my eyes on you.
Good morning, Sunday School. This is Mr. Charles. Let's get ready for worship service today by closing our eyes and bowing our heads in prayer. Dear God, thank you for another beautiful Sunday where we can gather together to worship your name, to study your words. God, thank you for everything that you provide in our lives. Thank you for all the blessings. Thank you for watching over us and keeping us all safe. God, I pray that you'll open all of our ears and our hearts to accept your word. Please bless Pastor Joy as she gives today's sermon. I pray that you'll continue to watch over everybody in the coming week. In your son's name we pray. Amen.
A new part of our worship called the Apostles' Creed. The Apostles' Creed, we say it as a way that we are confessing out loud, that we're saying out loud that we are believers of Jesus Christ. So let us say the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now, if you guys all have your Bibles with you, let us open up to John chapter 1, verses 1 to 2. John chapter 1, verses 1 to 2. And we will all stand up as we read our scripture reading together. So I'll give you some time to look up the verse. Now let us all read our scripture reading together. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. John chapter 1, verses 1 to 2. Amen. Okay, boys and girls, did you guys know that in your Bible, there are two parts? There is the Old Testament and there is the New Testament. So in the Old Testament, we started off by the book of Genesis, which is the first book of the Bible. And then last week, if you guys remember, we ended it with the book of Malachi. Now today, we're going to start off with the first book of the New Testament, and it is called the book of Matthew. Now, if you guys open up the Bible to the book of Matthew in the New Testament, Matthew chapter 1, it shows you something really, really interesting. There's a lot of names, all different types of names, starting off with Abraham, as you guys might be familiar, Abraham, and going down to Jesus. Now, this chapter is called the genealogy of Jesus Christ. What is genealogy? That's a big word, right? Genealogy is just another word for family tree. Have you guys ever heard of family tree? Have you guys ever seen one? If not, here we go. This is called a family tree. Now, if you guys see at the very bottom, we see it starts off with me, and then it has mom and dad, and then my mom and dad also have mom and dad. They're also called our grandparents, right? We have grandma and grandpa, and then our dad's side, we have grandma and grandpa too. And then if you go keep on going up, it's called great-grandparents, and then great-great-grandparents, and it just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. You know, Jesus' family tree also looks like this. You know, in Matthew chapter 1, it shows that Jesus' family started off with we all know who this is, Father Abraham, and then coming down in the line to our Savior Jesus Christ. You know, Jesus had a family that included his mother Mary and her husband Joseph. And as we see, going back, there were many, many, many other people before, like Abraham and David. You know, in the beginning, we see Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, and then we go down the line and we see Ruth and we see King David and Solomon. There are so many amazing people in the family line of Jesus. And I'm pretty sure you guys remember the stories that we talked about in the Old Testament. So, you know, as Jesus' family was chosen by God, and was guided by God in a very special way. God told his prophets that to pay attention to this family because in this family there's going to be the birth of Jesus, God the Son. You know, our Bible story point for today is Jesus had a family. Can you guys say that with me? Jesus had a family. Jesus had a family, which is true, just the same as us. But my question for today, and the question that we're going to be talking about for this next couple of weeks is Jesus God or is Jesus a human? Let's read this together. Jesus is both fully God and fully human. Jesus had earthly parents, Mary and Joseph, but his true father is God. You know, as we read more and more about our Savior Jesus, as we learn more and more about him, I hope that we can get closer with him and I hope we can fall in love with our Jesus more and more. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you so much for starting us off with a wonderful story of Jesus' family in the New Testament. We pray, Lord, that as we just learn more about Jesus, and as we get closer with you, Father God, we pray that we will not stumble, that we will not fall, but we will be able to stand strong and to get closer with you through the word. We thank you, Lord, and we pray this all in your son's name. Amen. Small group activity, let us bring out our new activity booklet and crayons and let us open up to page 3. And our activity for our kindergartners is called Find the Differences. Look at the picture on the top and then circle the 8 things that are different in the bottom picture. And for our first and second graders, our activity is called Family Portrait. So use the space provided to draw a picture of your family. After we are done with our activity, let's turn it around and color in our Bible story picture. After you're done, have your parents take a picture and send it to me.
Hi friends, I'm Megan.
And I'm Jessie. Hey Megan, guess where I'm going this weekend?
Where?
The lake!
Oh fun! Who are you going with?
My whole family. Let me think. So, my mom, my dad, my little brother, and my baby sister, and my grandma, my grandpa, my Aunt Dottie, my Uncle Ronnie, my cousin Lauren, my Aunt Sonia, my Aunt Patty, my Uncle Danny, my cousins David and Christy, then my cousins Stephanie, Shelley, Leanne, Taylor, Daniel, Lucas, and Camille. Oh, and my Aunt Jared, my Uncle Robert, my Aunt Mary, and my Uncle Richard. Oh, and then my dad's cousins, I don't know their names.
Wow, Jessie. It sounds like you're going to a family reunion this weekend.
Yeah, that's what my mom called it. Our whole family is getting together at the lake. My mom said I haven't even met some of the people who will be there yet.
Wow. Well, how fun to have such a big family. Did you know that Jesus had a big family?
No. Did he go to a family reunion?
I don't know, but I do know we will learn a lot about his family in today's Bible story. Listen to the story. Jesus is God's son. No one made him. He has always existed. God made the first people, Adam and Eve, but they did not obey him. All along, God planned to send his son to earth to save people from sin. When Jesus came to earth as a baby, his mother was Mary, the wife of Joseph. The Bible says that Jesus is different from any other person. He is both God and a human at the same time. God gave Jesus a family on earth. Jesus had parents, grandparents, great-grandparents, great-great-grandparents, great-great-great-grandparents, and so on. Jesus' family was big. Jesus was born into the family of Abraham and King David. Long before Jesus came to earth, Abraham had a son. His name was Isaac. When Isaac had a family, one of his sons was named Jacob. Jacob was part of Jesus' family too. Later, a man named Salmon was born into Jacob's family. He married a woman named Rahab. Rahab helped God's people by hiding their spies when they came to Jericho. Rahab had a baby named Boaz. Boaz grew up and became a farmer. He married Ruth. Boaz and Ruth had a son named Obed. Obed was the father of Jesse. Jesse had many sons, and the youngest was David. God chose David to be a king of Israel. Many kings were part of Jesus' family. David's son Solomon was a king. King Jehoshaphat was part of Jesus' family, and so was Uzziah, Ahaz, Hezekiah, and Josiah. God's people went home after being taken to Babylon. then, Shealtiel was born. His son was Zerubbabel. Later, Matthan came along. Matthan's son was named Jacob, and Jacob's son was named Joseph. Joseph is the man who married Jesus' mother, Mary. Joseph raised Jesus as his own son. Jesus is God's son, the one God promised to send to save people from sin. Jesus is God's son, but he came to earth as a human. He had parents on earth, Mary and Joseph, but his true father is God. God sent Jesus to keep his promises to Abraham and David. Jesus rescues people from sin and makes them part of God's family.
Now, the four for us to remember today is, number one, Jesus had an earthly family like us. Number two, Jesus' family included Abraham and David. Number three, Jesus is the fulfillment of God's promise to send a rescuer. Number four, Jesus' family line proved that he is the Messiah. Boys and girls, it is now time for offering. Let us take our offering, and with a ready heart, let us give thanks to our God. Let us sing God is so good as we give offering.
God is so
Lead the way. Help me be good every day. Let me know what's wrong and right. Keep me safe day and night. Let me know what you have plans. Lead the way, God. Hold my hand. Amen.
All right, boys and girls, I hope you guys are having a wonderful Sunday service so far. Just a couple of announcements I want you guys to know. First one, Lent season has started, and I hope you guys all have picked up your Lent package. If you guys haven't yet, make sure you let your parents know to come to church and pick up your Lent package. And second announcement, I know we started off the New Testament today, so we all should have our new activity booklet. If you guys don't have it yet, make sure you let your parents know because we have it ready for you to pick up as well. Okay, boys and girls, let us all stand up and let us close with the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. All right, boys and girls, I hope you guys have a wonderful Sunday with your family. I hope you guys have another great week of school. And I will see you guys again next week, Sunday, to worship our God. All right, boys and girls, I love you very much. Bye-bye. Creatures here below.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.